We're keeping our finger on the pulse of what's new in the science of reading and breaking down any important new studies that get released so you can stay informed on how to best support your students. We're calling this segment the Research Recap. Hey guys, it's Katie, your classroom connection to the science of reading. Since research is at the core of the science of reading movement, it's important for educators to stay informed on new studies that may affect instruction. However, today's teachers, literacy coaches, administrators, you guys are already incredibly busy, and few might have the time to sit down and sift through the dozens of dense research studies that are coming out. So this is why we want to do the work for you. We're keeping our finger on the pulse of what's new in the science of reading and breaking down any important new studies that get released so you can stay informed on how to best support your students. We're calling this segment the Research Recap. In this Science of Reading Research Recap, we're looking at a recent study called Text Types and Their Relation to Efficacy in Beginning Reading Interventions from Alia Pugh, Devin M. Kearns, and Elfrieda H. Hiebert. We're going to explore what this new study says about what type of text is most effective for helping children learn to read in small group intervention, decodable readers, or non-controlled texts. So let's dive in. First of all, what are decodable readers and what is non-controlled text? What's the difference? Well, decodable readers, also known as controlled text, are typically simple pieces of text that are designed for emergent readers and contain phoneme-grapheme correspondences that have been explicitly taught. Generally, these texts follow a sequence that aligns with phonics instruction. So simple phonic skills such as VC and CVC words will appear in the first decodable readers and gradually move towards more complex skills such as vowel tables. Non-controlled texts are reading materials that have not been written to control for specific phonics patterns or word choice. This is the type of text we encounter in authentic literature, things like textbooks, newspaper articles, etc. And this type of text includes both phonetically regular and irregular words. Non-controlled text exists on a readability continuum from very simple to complex. Now, let's take a look at what this new research is telling us about which one is more effective at teaching students to read in small group intervention and how the authors came to their conclusions. Through the examination of data from three meta-analyses, Alia Pugh, Devin M. Kearns, and Elfrieda H. Hiebert aim to investigate the relationship between the text utilized in beginning reading interventions, so decodable, non-controlled, both, or neither, and their impact on student reading achievement. The study posed the following question. Do the findings of reading intervention studies vary based on the type of text used in each study? So that's what we're going to look at today. So according to the background provided by the authors, not a lot of research has been done on the relationship between the types of text used in intensive reading intervention and the resulting student achievement. So that prompted the authors to conduct this study. And here's what they found. The authors found no significant differences in outcomes between the interventions using decodable and non-decodable text. Both groups showed similar effect sizes. Now, there are a couple possible reasons for this. So one is the simplicity of beginning text. So when we think about decodable readers and we think about early non-controlled text for students, they're both fairly simple. So that could be a reason why we're seeing similar outcomes. Also, there is really a lot of variation in how decodability is defined. The decodable readers in this study had all different levels of decodability. The third thing that could be impacting these outcomes was teacher training. Students who received intervention from teachers who have a lot of teacher training might have better outcomes. It's just one of those variables that they looked at. The most notable finding was that interventions using both decodable and non-controlled text yielded the highest effect sizes on foundational skills and comprehension measures. So these results indicate possible benefits of using more than one kind of instructional text for reading intervention. So not just decodable and not just non-controlled, but both together. While the authors of this study stressed the need for additional research focusing on text types and their impact on reading achievement outcomes, the initial finding of the study is that multiple text types, decodable and non-controlled, used in unison could be beneficial in reading interventions for struggling readers. So with that research in mind, both decodable and non-controlled text can have a place in beginning reading intervention. It's crucial that as educators, you consider your instructional purpose when selecting texts for students to read, no matter whether the texts are for Tier 1 reading instruction or reading intervention. and consider the possibility that a combination of text types might prove to be the most beneficial. Check the links below to read more about the research and subscribe to our Savvas Science of Reading newsletter.